Hello and welcome back to our playthrough of City Skylines in the wonderful metropolis of Quiarcusville here. Yes, odd name I know. Now, last time I was trying to sort out this road here. I was trying to get one way traffic get down this big thoroughfare and one way traffic up this thoroughfare. Well, I've looked into it. And it seems that there's a little bit of silliness going on here. You see, the game remembers the direction in which you lay the road. So, for this instance, I laid the road from north to south. Up here, came down this way. And that is the only direction in which it can go one way now. So if I want to make it a one-way road going south to north, I'm going to have to demolish this stretch of road, relay it starting from here and going up this way, and then make it one way. Silly. I imagine there's something in the game's code, perhaps in its algorithms, that make it that it has to be this way. Perhaps something to do with the way they model traffic, I don't know. But a little inconvenient, you'd think you'd be able to just switch it. So we're going to have a go here. This might be a horrific mess, but let's try. Oh, I'm going to regret this, I just know it. It's going to be more hassle than it's worth, I'm sure. Still, what's the old saying? A stitch in time saves nine. There we go. Now, let's get our road. We were six lane. We're going one way, we're going to start one way. And lead down to this one. There we go. First stretch done. Okay, so far so painless, actually. Oh, well, look at that. Completely and utterly painless. Thank God for that. Now, we should just be able to unpause the game. And we should have beautifully flowing traffic. Look at that. Isn't that pleasant? Of course, this probably means that I will have to upgrade these bridges here to carry more traffic. So I'm going to upgrade these. Shall I upgrade them now? How much would it cost? Can I upgrade them now? Slope too steep? No, I can't. So we're going to have to build... upgrade this one. But I don't think I could do this corner. That's the problem there. Problems, problems, problems. Never mind. We'll build another bridge further down, I suspect. So, where were we? We just finished building our first ore district here. You can see this is building up nicely. We've got some heavy-duty mining equipment here. I'm not quite sure that's how they do it in real life, but never mind. It's a nice representation. Again, just the detail in this game. Quite remarkable. What are you doing just parked there? Belong to Emma Young. Where's Emma Young? She works here, does she? Huh. And she lives at the Madison residence. Okay. Just the detail they go into in this game. The fact that I'm able to figure out where each of my citizens lives. It's simultaneously entertaining and a little creepy. You have to admit, just a little bit creepy. How are we doing for power? Time to put in some more turbines. Unless... no, let's just put in some more turbines for now. Some more wind turbines. Start to double up on this section. Still producing 7 megawatts. Good, good. We're only going to use these until such time as we can get a nice open body of water, perhaps down here somewhere, that we'll be able to put the advanced wind turbine in place. They generate more health. Good lord, what's that from? More energy and produce less noise pollution for your citizens because they're out in the river or at sea or in a lake. So, let's have a look at our milestone goal. Got to reach a population of 4,800. Oh, and we got public transport, didn't we last time? Yes, so let's have a look. It's time to put a hub in. Let's have a quick check of our traffic problems here. Heavy traffic along here. I thought that would probably be the case. I might have to upgrade this road. Bad congestion here. This is getting quite heavily used. Okay. So we may have to consider putting in a larger bridge across this point here. Get rid of this one, put in a larger bridge. Because these roads are getting quite heavily used, especially along here, see. As for the inner city sections, that looks okay. Is there any way to check our commute? That would be interesting, wouldn't it? Doesn't look like it. Not yet, anyway. So, congestion isn't too bad anywhere at the moment, so we'll just start putting in some very simple bus systems. We're going to put the bus depot. Where should we put it? Where are my zones? No real major shopping hub yet. We're going to put it... Yeah, I suppose we'll put our bus stop in here. At the edge of that terminal. There it is. I'm going to flap it in there. Kadunk! It's going to create some unhappiness, but never mind. Right, now we're going to start putting in our bus lines. Really? That has no power? Yes, you do. Stop lying to me. Go put in our bus lines. This involves putting in our bus stops and then connecting them up. So, where are our shopping districts? You've got shopping here, here, and here. And our main residential area is right up here. So we're going to make a loop, a couple of different loops. Make one around this section. And then we're going to make a longer loop around our residential area that leads to our industrial area. Just to try and relieve some of the traffic that's using these bridges. So let's start with the first one. Where shall our first stop be? Let's put our first stop slap bang in the middle here. Okay, there's our first one. It's going this way. So let's put our second stop down here. Making people happy. Good, good, good. We like to see happy people. Another one here. To here. Oops, the house is on fire. That's not a good sign. Let's stop off at this side and then come along. You have to go around here, I suppose. Okay. Stop here. Then here. And then let's go. Ah, oh, bop a bomb. Didn't cause too much consternation for our bus driver. Here and to there. You have to close it to finish it off. Now, if I close this up, we can see, our first bus is on the move. There you go, and look, we've got a fire back over there. What's going on? Yep, there's a fire engine there already. Good, 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 good. Anyway, look, there our buses go. Off they trundle, our coaches. Going into a bizarre loop here, picking people up. Good, good. It's time to put in our second loop then. Our second loop is going to start in the heart of the residential district. It's going to do a run on each block, I guess. Yeah, let's bring one down here. Anyone in to pick up? We'll put him a stop here as well so you can drop people off if you want to at the at the mining facility. Good lord. Went blank there for a second. Looks good. Good places to pick up. Now we're going to go over the road and we're going to drop off in the middle of our industrial area and come back to... Where did we start? There we did. We started up there. Now that's one of the things that could improve about this game. Different colours for different bus lines. Because otherwise, it gets a little confusing at times as to what stopped where. Oh, and we've unlocked the cemetery as well. I suppose we better put one of those in soon, hadn't we? But we should soon see buses starting to come out and do that new route. And with any luck, over time, when we check again, we should see some of the congestion start to alleviate. I'm getting a little bit of it, alleviation. Coming up a bit here as we get more people in. Okay, nothing too major. While we're here, let's have a look at fire coverage. Yeah, no fire coverage down here and absolutely none over here. Oops, we'd better put some more fire stations in, hadn't we? Firehouse, 12,000 for one. Well, this area needs it because they don't have one. So there we go. And we'll wait to put a new one in over here as well. You have power, don't lie. Go away, advisor. Okay, he's going across quite happily. There we go. I might end up widening these roads, don't know yet. Now this is going to cause problems, isn't it, eventually? Right, our next milestone was just to get an increase in population. So we're going to put in some beautifying buildings, I guess, around here. Make sure we're not blocking off any important natural resources. Nope, here looks okay. It's forestry land, we could build a forestry industry here if we wanted. But we don't. We're quite happy to just build this up as our residential zone. So, let's get our nice roads in again. Start building up. I'm going to start trying to build slightly larger blocks that don't have quite so many junctions, and I've noticed I'm using a heck of a lot of junctions very close to each other. And I'm pretty sure that in the long run, that will come back and bite me in the backside. So I'm going to try and do longer blocks with less frequent junctions. Don't know how that's going to turn out. Might turn out terribly. That means that we have to make some cul-de-sacs. Like that. Which I'm sure is terrible, terrible, terrible. Now I keep complaining about this intersection. Let's just have a look at the traffic. Yeah, that's a bad intersection, these roads. Seeing a lot of traffic, but they're coping at the moment. I may very well take this out and put a larger bridge in. Maybe down here. Let's finish this off first. Let's put our pipes in, and then we'll see to the roads. Because I've got the feeling that that's one of those things, traffic is going to be one of those things that comes back to bite you in the backside if you don't plan it correctly. Speaking of forward planning, our water's getting a little bit thin there. So let's put in another pump. There we go. Now we're going to put in another sewage treatment facility as well, of course. Or another waste pipe, I should say. They're not treatment facilities, are they? Sadly. There we go. Okay. How's the pollution looking? Not too bad yet. Not too bad. Right. Housing. Look at that. We can put all of that in. But we have to leave a little bit of space for a firehouse. Our crime is still pretty good. I think I'll put another police station in just to be on the safe side. Another firehouse. And how about medical? Health. Generally okay. What's going on down there? Why have we got so many fires down here? I wonder if we could enact smoke detector distribution. Now that should help bring down the risk of fire. Now these are city policies that you can enact. They affect the entire city in one go, which is quite handy, which just helps to do certain things, such as smoke detector distribution, significantly reduce the risk of fire, water usage helps to reduce the usage of water, so your one pump will go further, but it does cost per building, so you have to be making a little bit of money before you can enact them. I'm just going to speed up time here because we're going a little bit slowly, and I want to get enough money to build another fire station up here and another police what's it called? Police station? Yes, police station there. How big are they actually? I wonder if I could just... That's 3 1 2 3 by 4. So we could actually just use this to dump like that. And I imagine that the police station is the same. Let's just check it. Yep, police station is the same. Okay, they need a cemetery, do they? Yeah, but a cemetery is... We'll put a cemetery in there later when we have 8,000 credits to spare, which we don't at the moment. There we go. Right, that should be everything we need. Okay. That should start boosting our population up. And you can see, if you were paying attention, my income went down from about 2,000 a week to around about 800. And that's just because of that ordinance, that policy that I enacted. Uh-oh. We're getting little skulls cropping up. That's a bad sign. That means that there are dead bodies, I believe. And you don't want dead bodies piling up. A dead person is waiting for transport. Okay. I suppose our next purchase will have to be a cemetery for 8,000. So, a couple more seconds here, and we'll have enough for that. Ah, good lord, guys. Just burn the bodies. And you can keep them on your mantelpiece. There you go. Happy now? You happy now? Well, yeah, seemingly so. Lots of good cheer. And they're quite pretty. Let's face it. Nicely shaded and wooded. See what's happening with the rest of our city here. Yeesh. Still lots of corpses piling up there. They want industry and commercial still. Would it be tasteless to put commerce around the cemetery, do you think? Maybe a little. Maybe a little tasteless. Yeah, probably right, guys. But you know what? We're going to do it anyway. Because why waste good space? Ugh. That's nasty. We're not going to keep that piece of road. There we go. Okay. Let's put some commerce in here and here. I'll put some residential in. Residential in here. Maybe we can put a park or something in there. That'd be nice, wouldn't it? We can put a park in. We can. That's a little bit small. Ooh, that would be good, wouldn't it? Great big park in like that. Badunk! And I'll keep people happy as well. I'm all about making my people happy. Because happy people pay taxes. Da-da-da-dunk. Oops. Give them some water. There you go, guys. How are we doing now? Much better. Let's see how our traffic situation is doing now that we've put in. That's eased up a little bit. Still not very good here. It's improved along here. This road is still seeing a lot of traffic. But this junction, Yeah, this junction's going to have to go, isn't it? Let's see if we can do something about that. So, here comes the fun part. We've got to try and build these roads straight, but from here, which is just absurd. So we're going to build this one out first, give us a measuring stick against which we can align the other road like that, and then like that. Oh, we don't have enough money. Okay, we have to wait for a few minutes just for our cash reserves to build back up so we can put this second road in. Seeing you're not connected. No, I'm pretty certain you are, sir. We'll have to check in a sec. A little flashing symbol. Are we still going sped up? Yes, we are. Let's see if we can find something else to do. Why are you saying you're not connected? Don't know. Then we're going to put in another. What we'll do is we'll build an intersection across here. So we'll build a big road that goes just beneath this lagoon and across like this. And we can build a bridge that will connect both sides. Well, that's the plan anyway. Probably won't work, and we'll end up with a horrific mess. But hey ho, that's what these games are for. Okay, dunk. There we go. 4,800. Come on, tick, tick, tick. Nearly. There we go. Okay. Now you should both be one way. Now you're saying you're not connected, but you are. Well, that's okay then. It must just mean that it's not connected in a meaningful way to the city, perhaps. Now, this should be interesting. So we're going to have traffic heading this way, so that we'll be heading on the south side. Traffic will be going in that direction. Bring this down a little bit further. Okay, wow, we're building up. We've got a natural depression here. That's kind of cool. And this one, we're going to have a junction here. So we're going to have to build this one up, which is going to be awkward as heck. Never mind. I'm going to build out this way. No. That's not far enough down, is it? City planning. Who knew it would be difficult? Probably brought this one down too far, actually. Yeah, I think I have. I brought this one down too far to begin with. So what I want to do is this road's going to have to go up and over. This road will go underneath this road. So that's it's going to be awkward to do without. Okay. Does that look reasonably straight? No, does not, does it? That looks a bit better. Not quite right, but not too bad. Okay, and then we want to go up here so that we can cross over. That be enough, do we think? Should be. Whew, problems, 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 people. I'm sure I'm making this more difficult than it should be. Oh, not enough money again. That's fine. We can leave it suspended for now. And this should be able to come. Ah! I've done it again, haven't I? Look at that. Wrong way. I have to build back on myself. This is why this system is r quite ridiculous. Because you have to figure out your distances and build these things for the one-way systems to work without really having an idea of where they're going to be functioning best. And I just think that that's, for a game that does everything else so very well, that just seems a little bit silly. I'm going to try and curve around a bit back towards this road so that we can... No, that's a bit too close. Can we come around here? Yes, we can. Okay. Right, there we go. Blah! Messy. Messy, messy, messy. Isn't that messy, guys? Is indeed. So we're going to demolish that bit. I'm going to try and come in a little bit closer so that this bridge isn't quite so, oops, Daisy, horrendously massive. Like that. And then this bit has to come. As I was saying, it silly sloped too steep because now I've got to try and go backwards and connect. There we go. Okay. All that just that we can... Yeah. And that still doesn't work, does it? Because I still have to come over here. Oh, wow, guys. Wow, we're making a pig's ear of this, aren't we? Or aren't I should say. I am making a horrendous mess here. Road planning. Well. Okay. Let's think it through logically. Do we have any intersections that we can use? There's a clover leaf. Can we use highways yet? Yes, we can. Interesting. Okay. There's a roundabout. Kind of what we would really want. It's a big old roundabout here would make life very, very much easier. But look at the size of that thing. Roundabouts are awesome for traffic control. They work really well. But, good lord, look at how much space it takes. Okay. So we need to come up over here. I don't think we'll be able to do it. Look too steep. Can we? Oh, look at that. Just about. Yeah, we can just about sneak over there. And then we can come back down like that. There we go. Okay. It works. Honestly, guys, it works. After a fashion. After a fashion, it works. I'm going to bring this one in here like this. Does that work? Yep, and that traffic's all going that way, that traffic's all going that way, that traffic's all going this way, and this traffic's all going that way. Blah! Right. Okay. And we were doing this because we wanted to make connections down here, wasn't it? Oh, good lord, all this mess, just so that we can build some connections. So, we are going to bring this one up to... And that still hasn't really solved anything, has it? Ah, never mind. Never mind, it still gives us a good traversal across there. That was a mess. But it's there now. Let's just see if we can upgrade these roads to be anything bigger, perhaps. We can upgrade this. Just, let's pause it. Upgrade. I can't do that side, sadly. Okay. So, we shall put in a... A larger bridge, perhaps. I don't want it coming off of these roads because I don't want the junction to be here. So what I think I'll do is, if I can get the right bit used here. Come out to here. And then we're going to upgrade to our larger road. Come up here and come up. And we're going to switch to a curve. Enough money. Oh, of course we haven't got enough money. I've paused it, haven't I? Oops, can I unpause you? Thank you. There we go. I'll just come across like this, I think. Of course, it does mean that we've got to try and find a space that we could fit it in. Must be somewhere we can squeeze this in, surely. Maybe there isn't. Maybe we can do it like this, and then come across like this, perhaps. Yeah, that looks like it'll work. You can put an S bend in. Not the prettiest bridge in the world. Blech. It looks hideous now, doesn't it? We're probably going to have to delete that intersection that we just spent our time making, because it's really fouled things up. Okay. Then we can come around, and if we come down, we should be able to then... Should we come down this way? Yeah, let's come down this way. And that should enable us to carry more traffic across this intersection. Maybe we could even give multiple roads coming up to this one. Is that right? Can we do that? Okay, that kind of looks a bit weird, but never mind. Let's go back to our smaller road. Then we can come down now. Come down like that. We'll be able to bring it back up to this one here. Don't quite understand what's happening there. That looks strange. Shouldn't be a junction there, should there? How very odd. Very odd indeed. That does look like a junction, doesn't it? How much are we waiting for? 1880. Nearly, nearly. Oh, there we go. Okay. And we are going to demolish this, because I'm not happy with it. It looks horrible. And we'll figure something else out for this bit later on. There we go. Okay. That was a waste of money, wasn't it? One thing about this game, you really have to have a good idea of what you're planning for your city before you start building, rather than just throwing yourself into it like I have here. Never mind. Never mind. Let's continue building out. Got these bigger blocks. Oh, come on. Give me more money. Yeah, you want to. Am I going to be able to connect there? I might not be able to. Space already occupied. Okay, we have to bring it down a little bit further then. And connect up to this one here. There we go. Now we can bring a line down here. 1360. Come on, money. I want more money. Give me more money. Completely forgot about putting in our new firehouse, didn't we? Oh, there we go. Okay. That's that one done. Let's see. Really scraping the barrel with our resources. Thankfully, look at that, we're already piped in. Hallelujah. So we can just dump our new residential zones in here and really boost our population up. There we go. Pretty good, huh? That should give us a nice boost to our income as well. And let's just have a look, see how our landfill site, 69% full. Okay, it's getting close, guys. We're going to have to look to put another landfill site in soon. Oops, today's we've got a fire over here as well. And we've got some fire engines out here already, doing their job. Looks kind of hot. There's the donut van, delivering donuts to the burning building. Okay. Sure thing, guys. Sure thing, if that's what you want to do. You must really love your donuts. That's all I can say. Okay, let's see, how's the traffic situation? Really need to improve this stretch down here, don't we? Need to make these roads wider. So what I might do is briefly pause the game, take out these roads, and put in some of the wider roads so we can get more traffic along here. I wonder if we can upgrade this road system here. Upgrade this one. Bomb. 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 Okay, everything but that little corner there. That's fine. Just narrow, slightly narrower there, but that's okay. That's going to cause problems, isn't it? I keep doing these things and I don't think it through properly. Never mind. Let's not worry about that for now. Something we can come back and cry about to our heart's content later on. So where do we want industry to build up? Anywhere along this section. So out comes this road, down to here, up to there, up to there. There we go. And we'll put a split through here as well. Seriously, don't even have $800 anymore. There we go, okay. Industry, gdunk gdunk. Water, yeah, we're going to have to pipe in it. Put in a new pipe. Or, you could cost half the amount and put one in like that. There you go. I can be taught, it would appear. Our city here is building up nicely. What about transport? Yeah, we don't have any buses servicing this area, so we'd better put in something here, hadn't we? Let's create a new line along this route. Yeah, that looks good. A nice little winding route around here. And then back to the beginning. That should put them close enough to the other bus links that they are able to extend off of those into the new areas. Keep some of our cars off the road. Still saving up money for those. What I could do, I suppose, is take out a loan. 20,000 to have to pay back 21,000. Doesn't sound too bad. We can alter the budget, I suppose. Here you can bring down the amount of funding to services, which will affect the happiness of your people, etc., etc., and the efficiency of your services. But say I have an excess and overhead of power, which I don't. Yeesh. But say I did, I'd be able to reduce the electricity budget and save a little bit of money while not affecting my people overall. But that's not something we want to do at the moment. because we barely have enough power to keep the lights on as it is. Never going to get these fire stations built, am I? Something more important always cropping up. Of course, if I put a coal fire station in or something like that, I wouldn't have to worry quite as much. See, the coal fire station produces 40 megawatts, which is... two of those coal stations would be able to produce as much as all of those windmills, essentially. But they produce pollution, and I want to keep quite a green city. I mean, it's from a distance it looks quite pleasant, doesn't it? All these trees and little suburbs. Even our agricultural area is quite pretty. Don't know how big our agricultural zone is. Not very big. Let's just see how big our natural resources are. So what we might want to do is just paste down to this end here. Extend that district down. So we're going to get the big brush. Quite that big. There we go. And just bring it down like that, so that anything I build in this area will automatically turn into agriculture. And let's just check over this side. Yeah. Anything. We want to extend this one really around here. So let's get our brush again and just extend it around. Actually, I've just noticed that the soil is a different colour here. If we look, it's kind of a grey tinge to it. So that's a way. That's quite a clever way of telling us there's ore there, I'd imagine. So I'm going to paste onto that greyish area so that any... there we go. Any industry built here will automatically be mining. Pretty cool, hey? Pretty cool. Sunnyside Heights. Policies, yeah. Smoke detector distribution. Ah, okay, that's interesting. I didn't know you could do this. So you can alter policies per district. Now that opens a lot of possibilities. So what we can do is we can check and have a look at our city. So this area is fine. It doesn't need smoke detectors. Look, it's pretty well covered. This area does, however. So what we're going to do is we're going to paste in a new district here. Going to build up a new one here. So we've got a new district. There we go. Sycamore Heights. That's just a general district. So we're going to click here. Policies. Boom. Don't need a smoke detector there, do we? They've got the fire station already. So we should see our money, our weekly income, climb back up a little bit now. Whereas these guys, these poor sods, they definitely still need the smoke detectors. Huh. I like figuring stuff like this out. That's incredibly useful. And it's probably why they're there in the game. I wish I had discovered that earlier. I like this feature. Right. Oh look, we've got a lot more money has grown up while we've been prattling away. So, let's put in a fire station, just so I discover that I don't need it. Let's put it down this side, so that it will cover, overlap a little bit less with the existing ones. There we go. And let's start expanding out our road network again. Okay. I'm going to build this all the way down to the end here. Back up. There we go. Blech. Yeah, I keep saying it. I do so hate these straight road grid patterns, but they are just the best way of doing it, sadly. I could make these pretty little designs and wavy roads, but when you do that, you just lose so much in terms of build space. You lose a lot, and it's just not worth it ultimately. Not in my eyes, anyway. Right, there we go. Water, got plenty of water, so actually that's something we could perhaps budget down in future. Because we don't need this much water, we've got a gross excess of capacity here. That's not really necessary. So if I really wanted to increase my income, I could budget down the amount of water production. And that would allow me to save some cash. Now, they really, really want residential, so we're going to give them a lot of residential. And how's our schools coverage? It's looking pretty grim, actually. We haven't done a great deal with schools. Do we even have a high school? I don't think we do, do we? Not to my knowledge. Do we have an elementary school? Yes, we do. We have an elementary school. I remember putting it in over here, in Sycamore Heights. There it is. So, we need to put a high school in. Otherwise, we're going to start having problems attracting high-tech businesses, etc., I would imagine, in the future. So we'll put a high school in here, down this end of the neck of the woods. Commercial still needs quite a bit, so we're going to put in commerce. We're going to mark in some commerce here, like that. And keep ourselves expanding out. And we should probably create a new district here, shouldn't we? Let's see. Yeah. Oops-a-daisy. That's okay, we can clear it off later. It's no big issue. We can tidy this up in a little bit. So this is going to be our new district. There we go. Woodland Heights. Not very imaginative, are they? We're just going to get a smaller one. Is that a smaller one? I know there's a new parcel of land. Going to get a smaller brush and just tidy up these edges here. Make it easier for when we lay the next one. There we go. Donk. Okay. Woodland Heights. Everything's heights. Heights, 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 heights. I suppose I could rename them if I was so inclined, but I'm not at present. Okay, let's expand our agricultural industry as well down here while we're at it. Bring this down and up to here. Go, and this conveniently placed. There we go. Dump, dump. Nope, marquee tool. Nope, we want paint bucket. Flop, flop, flop. That's a bit odd, isn't it? Never mind. We've got water to this section. No, so we're going to have to bring down our water pipes. No, not there. Why are you trying to connect me there? There's some oddity going on there. Never mind. Ground control to Major Tom. Not a space oddity, just an oddity. There we go, okay. Just the way I was looking at it. And we should build up some more agriculture. Oh dear, it's starting to get waste bin symbols picking up. That means that our trucks are not getting across from here quickly enough. So let us see about increasing our road network a little bit. So we're going to build that out this way, and this we're going to build down this way so that we can connect. Can't connect to there? I can connect to there though, couldn't I? Not a very neat junction. Maybe if we curve it a little bit, go into freeform. And curve it in like that. That looks okay, doesn't it? Okay, there we go. This should allow traffic to come across here a little bit quicker. I know, crossroads and traffic. Yeah, they're causing a little bit of a tail up there, but nothing too major. We'll put it on the back burner for now. Famous last words. Let's just see how much space a high school takes up. Oh! Like a glove, like a glove. Okay. So we can fill this area in with dunk. There we go. Fill that area in with residential. Because the people are screaming, they want to come in. They're saying, let us in, let us in. There we go, nope. Because we have no more houses. Until we get to the point where we can build skyscrapers. Which isn't just yet. Got another fire here. Where's the local fire station for you guys then? Yeah. There it is, all the way out there. Okay, it's understandable then. Perhaps we need to build another fire station down this way somewhere. Yeesh. Got fire engines there though. Yeah, not too bad response time. Nearly got enough for our high school. Come on, we need 24,000. Okay. So another 2 weeks. Another 2 weeks, that's all it's going to take. Which isn't too bad. Yeah, we've got 562. If we look up at the top corner here. We've got 561 citizens eligible for high school. We have zero capacity. So one school can take... How many can you take? Does it tell us? Capacity. 1,000 tells us in the bottom right hand corner. So this will take care of all our educational needs for the foreseeable future. Which is good. Pardon me. Nearly got enough. Come on, another 400, 200. There we go. Dunk. And look at that big wave of happiness sweeping across the city. They're going, yay, we've got place to us and our children. Our children are no longer juvenile delinquents wandering the streets in hordes. And we'll just fill in that little bit there. There we go. So, Woodland Heights. We could actually name that, couldn't we? Woodland Heights High School. There. Operating normally. There we go. Woodland Heights. Let's just have a look at this. There we go. See, look at that. Looks like quite a nice building, doesn't it? Bad in a city high school, I suppose. Right, let's see, how about our crime? Still pretty awesome. Nobody coming down here, but doesn't seem to faze anybody. Do need another police station though. And health. Okay, we're getting a little bit unhealthy. Perhaps we should look at putting in another clinic. They're only 10,000. So that should maybe be our next long-term goal. Right, our short-term goal, sorry, our long-term goal is to achieve our milestone. Which we're going to make a little bit of a push for here as time is getting on. I didn't realise I'd been going quite so long. This video is going to be one of my longer ones. Yeah, to make up for perhaps the lack of a video a couple of weeks back. Or last week. There we go. Okay, see if this works. I don't know if this building style is going to work or not. Seems to make a little bit of sense to me building these little cul-de-sacs, as it were. There's probably some city planners that are scratching their head and thinking, what the heck is he doing? Didn't build cities like that. It's terrible. Terrible, I tell you. Yeah. Okay, look, we're starting to get rubbish piling up. I wonder if... Our I wonder if our landfill site is full. Let me just check on that. Yes, it is. Oh, dearie me. So, how much is a landfill site? 4,000. Okay. So that's become our number one priority all of a sudden. Now we're going to put our next one down here somewhere. Just to spread it out a bit. Might put it down here so that they've got easy access to this side of the city. Yeesh. Look at it all. It's clogging up, guys. It is clogging up. Yes, it is. So we're going to have to just wait until we've got 4,000. Let's super accelerate time. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. I'm going to put it... Where should we put it? Should we put it here? Yeah, we could put it there, couldn't we? I'd prefer it facing this road. There we go. And... plop. Let's put it back to 2 time. There we go. Yes, I know to grow the city. So I'm having to put it in place for rubbish. And now our landfill trucks, our garbage trucks, rubbish trucks, whatever you want to call them. There we go. Okay. Crisis averted for now. For now. Because that's going to come up again, isn't it? It's going to keep on coming up. I'm going to put some commercial in there as well. Okay. How much was that clinic again? 10,000? Yep, okay. It's going to take a long time to clear. That's the problem with these little problems. Once they creep up, they take a long time to clear up. Now that one's completely full. And I've got nowhere to take that rubbish. Unless I can empty it, in which case they'll split it between this facility and this facility. Now that might sound like a silly idea, because I'm not really gaining anything. But it does allow these garbage trucks to start working the city again. Which helps in the long run. Because then I have 30 rubbish trucks moving around the city, 15 per site, rather than just 15. Well, that's the hope anyway. We're still a long way from our population goal, aren't we? So, less chatter, more building. Because our finances aren't brilliant, but they're not terrible either, are they? Let's face it. We're doing okay, so we're just going to keep on building up this huge district here. Now I'm wondering to myself, just as I'm doing this, whether it'd be better just to bring them in from this side. Maybe. Let's give it a go. Let's see what happens if I just bring them in from that side each time. Whether that will have a net effect on traffic. Because although it would create more traffic along this road, it should leave this other side relatively free in comparison. There we go. And put in some water pipes. Dump, dump, dump. And we're going to have to put in another... Yeah, look at that. I knew we were going to have to put in another one of these. Still, we're making quite a bit of money at the moment. Not massive amounts, but enough. To where we can just get 6,000. Come on, I need about a week until we have enough money. Come on, come on, come on, come on. And nearly there. Another 5 and a bit. 3 and a bit. Come on. I'm going to put another windmill in. There we go. Okay. That will stave off our electricity problems for now. We're still having problems with rubbish, aren't we? I might have to put another rubbish centre down here. Let's see, is there any way of tracking garbage? Yes, there is. So, Yeah. Looks like I might have to put another one more centrally located, perhaps, down here. Or not more centrally located, but on the other side of this thoroughfare. I was hoping to keep it all monodirectional, keep it all on this one side, monosided. But it looks like I'm going to have to spread it out a bit more, because these fellas aren't doing the job. There's just too much rubbish. So, never mind. We don't have an incinerator either, which is a shame. When do we get an incinerator? 7,000 population. Okay. So I'm going to put this down here for now. Put it in the middle there. Okay. And that should help with rubbish collection. Now we can get some... There we go, so he was getting quite desperate for the removal of rubbish. I wonder if there's any policies we can enact. Recycling would probably help, wouldn't it? But for now, we're just going to keep it going as is. New parcel of land available. Yep, I could buy some of these, which I might do. I might buy down here, extend out down this way, or perhaps buy up here. If I can see, can I see? Yes, I can see resources. Ooh, we've got oil over here. Uh-oh. The bus depot is on fire. That's not good. Where's the fire department for this one? Right there. Seriously? Oh, at least they got there quickly. That's what we can say about that. Let's see. So close to our goal. Do we have any more buildings to build up? A few more. Let's just accelerate this. We're starting to get brownouts. Not blackouts, but a brownout, which is just a little lack of electricity. So, plomp. We'll plomp another one down. We nearly had enough for our clinic as well. There we go. Just accelerate time again. The cap was just saved by the fire department? Of course it was. Our fire department's quite efficient. Look at fire. Yeah. Crime. So fire department's going to have some work down here. Let's just put in another... Should we extend Woodland Heights? Does Woodland Heights still have... Woodland Heights still gets smoke detectors. We don't really need the Woodland Heights to have smoke detectors, do we? Oops, we don't want to delete it, we want to put one in. There we go, that's better. I want this to be a separate district. Strawberry Hills. That sounds quite pleasant, doesn't it? Not quite Strawberry Fields, but Strawberry Hills. I wouldn't have said this was particularly hilly, but who am I to judge? There we go. And perhaps if we just bump it down this way. It's about the width of another one, isn't it? There we go. Oh no, I want you guys to be... Can I not just... Oh, I see. Okay. You have to extend it in, don't you? That's a shame, because Belmont Square sounded pretty awesome. There we go. Okay, 4719, 4720. We're very nearly at our... Oh, good lord, we're still using so much electricity, guys. Use less. There we go. How much does that give us, actually? Once it comes online, electricity production 107. Yeah. We're not getting out of there in a meaningful way, are we? So let's build another one. And... Yay! There we go! Population milestone reached. We can now build pretty roads. Oil power plant, hospital, fire station, police headquarters. Unique buildings, such as shopping, we've already done. Anything else? 10,000 squares, 500,000 money. We'll have a look at those later. To level 3 from 0, city in motion. I haven't touched any of these achievements. I've done a couple of them. Medical player, click on a police building. Okay. Interesting. Medic. Pioneer. Unlock all city services. Rolling in dough. Good lord. Anyway, never mind. That is, I'm afraid, all that I have time for today. So, we've reached our next milestone. Next time when we come back, we're going to push for our... What's our next one? 7,000. What do we get at 7,000? We get the metro. Also get our dense commercial and residential office zones, and we get our incinerator and our university. So next time, in our next episode, that's what we'll be pushing for. But for now, hope you've enjoyed what you've seen. Like, comment, subscribe. Follow me on my various online incarnations, and I will see you next time. Bye bye for now.